So the next case is proper cantilever beam with center point load. So far we have discussed the center simply supported beam with center point load, eccentric point load, UDL, and then fixed beam with center point load, eccentric point load, UDL. Now the next is proper cantilever beam. So the for proper cantilever beam case, consider the first case, proper cantilever beam with center point load. So now this is a proper cantilever beam. So now let us see, let us take a proper cantilever beam of span L, A and B. So this is a proper cantilever beam with fixed support at A and injured support at B. And for this beam, here we are having a point load exactly at the center, W, L by 2, L by 2. This is at the center, C. So total span is L by 2. So AC is L by 2 and CB is L by 2. Now, what is the first step in the calculation of collapse load? Come on, everyone. Think. So what is the first step? So first step is calculation of DS. So what is DS in this case? DS is nothing but we know number of equations of number of unknown reactions in excess of equations of equilibrium. So here loading is vertical. So we have to consider only vertical reactions. Here one and here one and here moment. So total reactions are three. So here no need to consider horizontal reaction. Only consider vertical reaction and then moment. So 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 minus the equations of equilibrium to be considered are sigma x equal to 0, sigma y equal to 0 and sigma m equal to 0. But no need to consider sigma x equal to 0. The reason no horizontal load, so no horizontal reaction. So DS is 1. So what is the next step? Calculation of number of plastic injuries required. So number of plastic injuries required is DS plus 1. So which is equal to 2. So now here we require 2 plastic injuries. So after calculating the number of plastic injuries required, we have to locate okay, where those plastic injuries are forming. So now if you see, we have discussed where the possible chances are there for the formation of plastic injuries. So now where they are? At fixed support, no doubt, and at under the point load, in the span under the point load. See, here this is not a fixed support, here injured support. So at injured support, it is already in a hinge. So the plastic hinge will not form here. Agree or not? So here at B, it is either injured support or roller support. So they are already hinges. So no. So the again forming the plastic hinge at those locations will not make any sense. Okay. So the two locations. But here we have to see the sequence. Okay, sequence, or you can say order of the formation of the plastic injuries, which means whether they are simultaneous or sequential, we have to decide. So that we are going to decide based on the bending moment diagram. So if we draw the bending moment diagram for the proper cantilever beam with center point load, so the bending moment diagram will be like this, cantilever beam with center point load. So this is a BMD. So if we see the value, so here this is WL by 32 and here it is 3WL by 16. Then obviously where the bending moment value is more, at support the bending moment value is more, clear. And here less, so sagging. So your hogging is more than sagging. So as I said, always you can take it for granted. At fixed support only the bending moment value is more, or the hogging bending moment is more, clear. Now first plastic hinge will form at A and at C. After that the second hinge will form at C. Now if we see the diagram, I can say the mechanism diagram. So this is a mechanism. So this AC rotates in. So this AC rotates in anti-clockwise direction. And that too the hinge is formed exactly at the center. So here it if it is theta. So here also it is theta. So that BC rotates in anti-clockwise direction. Now we know that according to the principle of virtual work, external work is equal to internal work. So external work is done by this load. So this load into the displacement delta. So the delta here is, we know that CC dash. So CC dash is equal to delta. Delta is equal to L by 2 theta. Agree. So now external work is equal to W into delta. Internal work is equal to, as here the plastic hinge is formed at A. So obviously the here it can develop plastic moment opposite to the rotation MP. And at C, it forms a plastic hinge. So, MP and MP. And C, at B, there is no plastic hinge. So, no need to consider MP. So, we have to consider MP where the plastic hinge is formed. That's it. So, now MP into theta at A plus MP into theta plus theta. Agree. So, now L is, delta is L by 2 theta. So, now W L by 2 theta is equal to 3 MP theta. So, now we can cancel theta and theta. We can cancel theta and theta. So, finally, the collapse load in this case, that is proper cantilever beam with center point load, collapse load. So, W is 6 MP by L. So, this is the collapse load in this case.